Not labeled, what do you think is labeled?
Fox and Hound.
What is Fox and Hound?
Toner.
A toner.
Toner.
Fox and Hound is an old term. If you're talking to anyone, you're going to want to say toner. That's really the term that people are going to use and know. So, and I don't think there's a single question on the quiz or test is going to say Fox and Hound.
Okay.
I don't know why they even have that in the book. Use toner. Toner is really the answer.
If we said Fox and Hound, is it?
Fox and Hound, I'll give you it for this time, but if you write an essay question and say Fox and Hound, I'm going to mark it off.
Right.
It's toner. Toner is the answer.
Okay.
Like I said, I can't ever recall anyone ever calling it Fox and Hound. Okay, have you ever heard it called Fox and Hound? So, anyway, it's a toner. Laptop doesn't have built-in NIC. What are we going to use?
RJ45 connector?
No.
No, so it's
serial port.
So what's it called? Remember what would we put our PCMCIA cards into?
Slot.
It's a PC card slot. So remember, if you look at the sides of your laptops, if you don't have a NIC in there, or you don't have a USB connection, you have PCMCIA cards. They're the credit card size little cards that we can slide into our computers. I know they're becoming less and less popular, but it is an important thing that you need to understand. PCMCIA card goes into a PC card slot.
Is that anywhere in the book?
Page 123 in your book.
Okay.
What would you say?
Well, you already answered.
Okay. Yeah. So page 123 will.
PCMIA slot.
PCMCIA card is what you're actually putting in, but it goes into a PC card slot. So PCMCIA is the actual card.
Considered
Chapter 5? No, you wouldn't be able to go through serial, but the reason being, your serial port connection, remember that that's not fast enough to do a NIC. You don't have enough bandwidth there. So, if you got a broken cable, what do you got to do?
Replace it.
You've got to replace it. There's nothing, you can't repair broken cables, you have to either replace basically you have to replace it. Essentially you're replacing it. Generally if you have a broken cable, the issue is you don't know where it's broken. I guess sometimes, yes, if you have it really bunched up and cranked right at the end, you'd see that. But most of the times, if I have a run from here all the way to the computer lab upstairs, I don't know where it's broken. Somewhere in there, I got to pull it out and replace it. That's the actual protocol that they give you is the CIA, EIA. You got a broken cable, replace it. You don't go try to find where it's broken. You just go and replace it. Because you don't know where it is. First thing, if you're an installer, what do you got to do?
Floor plan.
You got to get a floor plan.
Floor plan diagram.
That's absolutely critical. There's nothing worse than going into a place and not having a floor plan and saying, okay, you know, where am I going to go? How am I going to plan this out? That's really the first step to doing any type of networking right there is a floor plan. Any questions over the quiz? For chapter 6. I have here one genuine copy of the test, and we can go over it. We're going to go over this tonight. Then we're going to get to our lab here. I'm going to put it in the testing center right after class. So stay in time from right after class tonight until the 24th at 5 p.m. which is our next class period. Next Thursday. If they come and pull these before class that night, please don't be in there at 5 o'clock. I will pull them. So please make sure they're done before that time. So there's no class on the 22nd, which is Tuesday. So you get time any time between now and then, or you can take it during normal class time next week on the 22nd. Any questions on scheduling of the test? Okay. I want to give you some key highlights of things to know. You guys want to take some notes here? There's literally 73 questions, three of them are essays, worth 10 points each. So 70 multiple choice, true, false, and then three essays. Three essays, understand how you're gonna hook switches, hubs, things like that together. Understand how the downfalls of certain ways of doing that and the correct way of doing it. Maybe even be able to understand, you know, if you're in a bind, how would you do it if you don't have the proper equipment? There's several different ways you can do that. And we reviewed a couple ways that can cause problems, so make sure you understand all those. Know the difference between a hub and a switch. This is huge. I have some big points on this one, this essay question. I'm telling you the essay question, actually. You probably shouldn't do that. Be extremely detailed. I'm going to look for that you know every single little bitty detail of what the difference is, because it's very important in networking to understand those differences. How they function, what the security flaws are, all those types of things. I mean, I'm basically giving you the question. So you guys should know that, be able to write the essay question, and no one should miss any points in that, because you guys should know that very detailed. It's extremely important. That's why I'm giving you the chance to study.
Between the difference between
the purposes. Yep. In that, I would ask that you explain the difference between a switch and a managed switch as well. So, a managed switch. I don't ask that you know extreme detail, but just understand the difference and be able to give you some examples of the differences there. I make this too easy. I gotta be more vague here.
I'm very proud of a managed switch. Did we talk about that?
Yes, we did.
Good.
Yeah, I lectured on several points.
Okay, I'm just kind of block it out, I guess.
Yeah. Patch panel, labeling, understand those. That's the question on that kind of stuff. You know, if you run into a problem in that situation, what are you going to do? Let's go back here. Understand the types of Ethernet that are out there. I remember I gave you guys a couple specific ones. I think there's four specific types of Ethernet. Chapter 5 that I wanted you guys to know. You have something to know everyone. I'm not going to test on everyone, but I gave you a couple specific ones that I wanted you to know and understand. Hubs and switches, there's a lot of information on those. Understand that. 10 base T, the type of cabling required, length requirement nodes for those networks. Like I said, not every network. You're going to kill yourself if you try to know all of them, but understand those four big ones that I gave you. Understand the cabling. Remember we did our lab, we dealt with the pins, the pairs that transmit, receive, understand all of them, how that works, which ones transmit, which ones receive.
Are we going to need to know the color scheme?
No.
Okay.
But you better understand the concept.
Yeah.
And understand what the hub and switch does, what the role of the hub and switch is in that color scheme. bridges and repeaters. Know what they do and the difference between the two.
What was it?
Hubs and repeaters.
Bridges and repeaters.
I'm sorry, thank you. Bridges and repeaters. Know what a crimper does. You should, of those type of networks that I gave you, you should know what their speeds are. You should know what type of cabling they need of the four types. Understand.
What was the, yeah, I got that. What was the
four? What the STP and UDP are and what the difference is.
I'm sorry,
STP and UDP. What are the differences that they used?
STP and what?
UDP.
UDP?
UTP.
Oh, okay.
I'm sorry, I may be, if I'm stumbling, I'm sorry. Understand the rack mount system that we talked about. Understand patch cables, the reasons for those. Drops, horizontal runs, all those things that were on the quiz that apparently was not as easy as I had hoped last week after grading them. understand those questions. What's a drop? What's a run? What's a floor plan? What's a work area? Understand all those concepts. What's a D-mark?
A what?
A D-mark.
D-mark.
Know what, I think page 110 talks about the cost for network installation. I have a question on that.
Why don't you never use the question that's on the book where we have for homework?
Why? Because you already did those questions.
Can I have that question?
There you go again.
I want you guys to know the material, not the questions.
What?
You
give me 5 minutes of the test and I'll know all the material.
Let's see what else. I know what LED is, what it stands for.
What?
LED. 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 What it is, what it stands for. Understand what the lights are on the NICs. There's a couple of lights both on NICs and on hubs and switches. What are the common light things that light up and what do they signify? That's a pretty good overview of the whole test. All the essays? 30 total. So there's 70 points, and I threw in a gimme in here. So 70 points plus 30 points for the essays. 30 points plus the first results for the essays. Any questions?
Is this 2 through 6?
No, 4 through 6. And it's only 5 is limited to those 4 types of networks. So it's really only 2 and a quarter chapters, 2.5 chapters, however you want to look at it. So, any questions on that?
No, sir.
Okay. I want to finish up real quick the section on NICs, and then we're going to get to our lab here. So, I'm going to lecture on this.
Grab a new computer.
The portion on NICs.